Challenging, frustrating, and enjoyable all at the same time. This game was released in 1982, and fortunately, seen a comeback on Xbox Live. And I think Xbox Live is tremendous. Xbox Live Arcade, bringing back the old school games from the 80s and platformers from the 90s. And I don't have I can't say enough good things about Xbox Live. Not only does it bring back these great old school games, but it brings them back in high definition. You can play them through your HDMI cable into an HDTV. It's just tremendous. Xevious is presented in its original native aspect ratio as you would have played it in the arcade, just like a television laid on its side. It probably looks very familiar to those of you who have played games like Raiden. There's so many games in this genre now. As a general rule, I think they're more popular in Japan than they are over here in the States. And I think that's unfortunate. But I personally like you know, on this show, I love being bone, daring, starfish, countless enemies, impossible odds, on a questionable big mission. That usually doesn't matter anyway. Because, you know, what's the point of this game is to get through it, to have fun, to rack up points, shoot things and watch them blow up. Xevious came out in the arcade in 1982 and has since been seen on game systems like the Atari 7800 and the NES. And in fact, the original Classic Game Room series, we reviewed the Atari 7800 version and a version for the PlayStation, which they made. As you can see from the screen, you have two different weapon options. That's one of the things that makes Xevious unique. But for starters here, you have your lasers, your twin cannons, I think they're lasers, maybe they call them something else, and your bombs. So you have to shoot your enemies in the air, and also bomb the enemies on the ground. And they're all shooting at you from different directions, and it's very challenging. What makes this game decidedly different from Raiden 3, for instance, which is one that I recently reviewed, is that you can't power up your weapons to have this arsenal that fills the entire screen with your weaponry. You're basically limited to the two weapons that you start with. So instead of getting a massive, huge shotgun burst of red bullets that most vertical beams have, or a special weapon that you can blow up and then eliminate all enemy fire when it's about to kill you, you really have to rely on some serious skill dodging the enemy fire. Now, I generally forget the story of Xevious. You can find it online, I'm sure. But you do encounter a couple bosses as you continue on. And wave after wave of enemies, the variety of enemies changes on you. And my favorite part of this game, something I've loved since I was a kid and played this on my Atari 7800, is those spinning metal plates that come at you. At the time, those were amazing, that kind of graphics, the video game was just unbelievable. Xevious was way ahead of the time. And you can see why it influenced the genre so much. Just these simple things like, you know, tank boats in the water. You can't just bomb them, you have to actually beat them with your bomb and hope they run into it. So it requires a lot of skill to hit all the enemies and rack up serious points. And with Xbox Live, of course, they need to be added to set gamer points, which are addictive and a lot of fun to collect for all apparent reasons. The other great thing about Xbox Live, of course, is that your score ranks up against everybody else, and friends of incredible about Xevious is that this game came out in 82, and it really doesn't look any different than newer games today. Maybe it's slightly different, but there's only so much you can really do in two-dimensional vertical scrolling game before it starts getting ridiculous. I'm not a big fan of adding in all this three-dimensional polygon graphical floating all over the screen. I think keeping it simple like this is the way to go. That's why I like Xevious so much. It's pretty pretty. I'm generally not a huge fan of using the Xbox 360 controller on this game. It's definitely challenging for the arcade style choice of the buttons, but you know, what do you need to do? You don't have to stand up Xevious on a big chain placement. Xbox Live is about the best thing to have. So it does require some skill to hammer away at the button and also remember to draw the precise pattern. It's not a game where you can just hold down and fire. It does give you an option to do a manual shot where you can fire at the rate that I'm firing now. And also I use mine as a trigger to hold down the auto fire. So if a wave of enemies come at me, I hold down that trigger. Let's off the machine gun first. Whatever reason, music, even though it repeats itself over and over again, it never gets old. And maybe that's just because the music is that awesome. Here's a metal switch. Look at that. 20 years ago, that was incredible. They're tough too, you have to dodge those things. You can't blow them up, so you have to dodge them. And then the enemy fire is coming at you, and then you know you get caught in between the enemy fire and the spinning metal plates, and it kills you. I love to see the resurgence of arcade titles on Xbox Live. And they don't cost much on Xbox Live. A game like this is only about $5, and it really has infinite replay value. Even if you went out to find this for your Atari 7800 or NES, it would still cost you at least $5 or $6 when you add in shipping costs. The Xbox Live, you just download it, it's no problem.
I can see daylight!
No, I'm by no means the greatest Xevious player in the world. I'd like to get a lot better in this game. It really is one of my favorite games and always has been. Find the time to sit down and get back into it. One of my favorite game systems is the Atari 7800, and that's one that I grew up with and had when I was a kid. And Xevious was
Atari
2084 for us. That's my favorite game on the Atari 7800. I played hours and hours.
How do I stay creative?
And I'm glad to see that there's still a lot of interest in Xevious today. If you like this genre and you've never played Xevious before, you owe it to yourself to pick this game up on Xbox Live or the 7800 or the NES, and you've got to play Xevious. If you're really hardcore, you can go out and buy a real stand-up coin-op Xevious machine like they would have had in the arcades in the 80s, and you can put that in your living room, in your house. Wife can come home and be like, where's all the furniture? Like, put it outside because we got a Xevious machine. You know, she may start to get red and get mad at you. Well, why do you need furniture when you have a Xevious machine? The whole point is to stand there and play Xevious. I mean, it's only common sense. It's like replacing your dining room table with the cocktail version of Ms. Pac-Man. You can eat on that Ms. Pac-Man machine and play Ms. Pac-Man at the same time. Hell, it worked at Pizza Hut.